Hello, yes, we're working. Hey guys, how are you doing? Welcome to another Pokemon Crystal Kaizo Plus video slash stream. So I didn't get to play too long yesterday. I had a few good things to get up to instead. But we have made a little dent in Route 40. So 40? Yeah, 40, 41, something like that. And this place is actually quite scary, judging on the first couple of battles that we've had. But we're making our way through it. Just gonna boot up this because I can actually give it to my Slowbro. Should have done this a little bit sooner, but oops. I actually got rid of Bubble Beam. That's okay. I'm gonna get Surf as well. Fuck's sake. Let's do that before we make another screw up. Okay, Surf here. And we'll kick Water Gun. Don't think there's anything else to learn there that I should be thinking about right now. Fire Beam stays there. Oh, it's already on order. Great. Change those two things. I think there should be something else that I should be doing, but I'd rather go Ice Punch instead of Headbutt. Yeah. This is definitely the best way to go. Now we got some good special moves all around now. FI. Ice Punch, Psy Beam, Surf. It's got a considerable upgrade all of a sudden. Yeah, I remember like looking at this next fight and being like, oh shit. I don't like what I'm up against here. Okay, let's see what we can. So I think I plan to open with Fortress, yes. And then I have Tangela come in on the next one to deal with the other three. Jolteon is backup for Kingler. Backup there. Yeah, I think Tangela does a great job. Okay, let's go for it. I think 42 is probably about the right level to be at. What have I got for this? I go Quicklaw. Quicklaw, the counter to Kingler is Quicklaw. Sounds fucking strange, but it makes sense in a way. Anyway, where are we going? Oh, right, okay, we're on Route 41, not this way. Evidently. Okay, here's the horrible back to back. I hate, like I was saying in the last video how much I hate this design. Give them all Quicklaw, give them all Guillotine, and it's not even about your skill anymore, it's just luck. It's like, come on man. Be realistic, the game's challenging with the variables anyway, but this sort of level variables is absolutely ridiculous. Absolutely ridiculous. So, pin missile. Okay, they just double-edged me. Don't even use Spore. And first Quicklaw proc of the battle. Oh, nice hit. So we should be able to... Wow. Two procs already. Two procs. In the first two turns. That is pretty insane. Tentacruel. Tentacruel should be bombing off Surf. Now... I had something in mind. Oh, it was a speed thing. Yeah, I think I'd go with Poliwrath here. Oh, no, it was the one who tackles the Sneasel, that was it. So here I go Slowbro with the side beam, that's it. There we go, that was the plan. Slight risk, but there shouldn't be a risk. Okay. Jesus, despite having super effective move, still was a little bit of a problem for the Slowbro. What do we got now? So this should be Feint Attack. Which is why we should run Poliwrath into this, really. Then we smash him in the face. Smosh. Okay, that's the first one. This is the bullshit one. So this should be Earthquake. And it also has Sludge Bomb, which hits hard. But this is where Mega Drain should come and help us out. If it crits, it can kill us, but there's, actually, I mean, to be fair, it could just kill us straight up. I thought it was going to be a little bit more concrete than it is. Yeah. It's fine. It'll be fine. We won't die. We won't get crits. We won't get crits. We've already had enough procs go against us, so... Pinsir. Okie dokie. Pinsir. Double edge. I think we should stay in for just one. Meh. Do this, it's fine. It's okay. Can take the hits. Or take a hit, I should say. This could literally be anything right now then, right? Probably no, it will be submission again. It will be. I think we go here. Now we can one tap, we go faster as long as it's not a quick claw. Waterfall kills. Excuse me? What? Huh? That shouldn't have happened. I'd have to watch that back, but I swear to God he had less than 69% health. Because that was my minimum hit. Unless I'm seeing things. I'm sure that was the case. Anyway, Kingler next. Kingler was submission, get max 74. It's a low roll 73. So we are gonna stay in here. But I will have to switch out next turn. Let's just go waterfall, I suppose. Critical. Sub. And then should be Metal Claw. It gets him in cheaper. Alright, I guess we'll just do do this switch for safety. And then, oh fuck's sake. It would be Crab Hammer actually. Crab Hammer, yeah, we would die to a crit, so. How much health? Probably about 25% ish. Submission will finish him. Cool. Again, very uncomfortable fight. They're all uncomfortable. I don't think I played it the best though, to be honest. I don't think I did. Right, got one more back to back now. So let's see about putting another team in. Oh god, man. Okay. Jesus. Right, what options have we got? Oh. Hydro Pump will one shot the Nidoqueen right off the bat. That's always nice and welcome. It's always very welcome. Jesus, what a bulky grass type you got there. Very bulky. Flying types do the most. They're very good damage, in fact. And if I do, it'll probably have to be. Wow, this looks hard. It looks very tricky. Let's figure a way through this, shall we? Alright, I think we could open. I think it's really simple. Just open with Polly or Feraligatr could do it. Yeah, even Vaporeon actually could too. What about Kabuto? Kabuto could. As long as he hits the Hydro Pump, he could. And then he does a very good job in Tefiro too. How do I want to do it? That's the question. So yeah, let's run, hang on, let's check the levels a second. 42. I want to split the experience as much as possible. Let's start off with Pharrell, and we'll just deposit everybody else, and then we'll pick the rest according. Okay, so open with Faradagate, yeah, we could go with the Mystic Water for a guaranteed kill. Mystic Water. Okay, that's fine. And then versus Ancient Power on the Tangler with Quick Claw is a huge problem. It's definitely would want Nidoking for this, because I don't want to be enticing the Ancient Power if I can help it. I think having Nidoking here would be good. And then, Mechanium for Lantern. Not really thought about the ins and outs yet, but yeah. I think we definitely want a fire type. Tangela and Blossom, they take the damage so darn good, it's actually quite sickening. Who do I go for? Like, they take this fire damage so darn good, I don't even do 40% to them. Oh my god. See, Firo to finish off Tangela, but that doesn't really work. Because of the threat. This is so troubling. Jesus, how do you approach this? Oh, we'll definitely be bringing Fori along again. Jesus. Okay, so that's kind of like, so I've got Nidoqueen covered. Nidoqueen is sorted. The lantern is somewhat sorted. I think Nidoking is again, good answer, or I say good answer, but just it do a good job. I say that I think I give Fortress into the Tangela. This is bad though, because that's gonna bring. That's gonna force him to use the Pancient powers. If I get Fortress in to do one, pin myself and switch to Nidoking. I think with Nidoking, I should probably be. Susceptible. If they get so many things together in one turn, like I can't deal with it. Like I just won't be able to deal with it. Like they'll be able to take too much damage. And also there's fucking sleep powder. This thing's a nightmare. Sleep powder, ancient power, Giga Drain, Petal Dance. This thing's a nightmare. If they get the proc, which is basically anything that does super effective damage into it. Yeah, right. This seems shitty. I can't lie. I think I'm gonna push to 43, honestly. That's how respectful we're gonna be towards this fucking Tangela. I think if I push to 43, with some of them, not all of them, my fire types, bird. We're just in fucking trouble. I'm just in trouble versus this thing. It's just problematic. Looking at everything, like, oh my days. What about my own Tangela into the Tangela? Nah, it's just the recipe for disaster. It's just gonna invite shit, isn't it? I can't even see it on the list. Where is it? There. You just do ancient powers and eventually get procs and you'll die, so you can't even, that's not even a suggestion. Okay, let's think about how the fight goes. Okay, yeah, you one shot and then he brings out the Tangela instantly. Then it's going to be a Petal Dance and Giga Drain. Even that does like almost 50% to Nidoking. So the first turn I would switch to Fortress, then maybe we just do two pin missiles. Maybe I run Quick Claw as well actually on him. Oh no, I can't. I need to sleep. I need Lumberry. Okay, that's fine. Lumberry, and then just hopefully kill him before he gets any procs. Okay, that's fine. I don't think that's gonna be too bad. And then in will come Firo with Sky Attack, but I want to preserve Fortress. I'll want to preserve the Fortress, so then I would just switch to. I think like a rock type. Yeah, I mean my cargo seems like a good choice, or it's Kabuto, but Kabuto's not really doing Kabutops rather, sorry. Rhydon? Rhydon's not doing anything for the rest of the fight though. If he's gonna come in and do sky attack, you can just come in one shot with the electric type. That seemed a little bit better. Maybe not actually. Because he has focus band. I mean, I could bring, it won't be Jolteon, it will be my little sheep. Where's my little sheepy? Sheep's fine because sheep does fine in, oh wait, oh no, I got a better solution. Deposit you, we don't need sheep. We'll bring ghost. Ghost deals with the Azumarill like it's nothing because it can't hit. So then it's just a case of, maybe I don't use Nidoking, those four. And then, yeah, so I guess we go with this. It gives me something. It doesn't absorb the ice moves, does it? Actually, it does. It does. Yeah. Okay. There is that, and then. So that's the first three dealt with, and then it's the Blossom. Who I should have a little bit of life left in Fortress, perhaps. Feraligatr isn't really going to do a job there, are you? I'll tell you what, Meganium can come in and do a job. That's fine at that point. Double edge. Yeah, I think Nidoking has a place versus this one, the Blossom. If we go, I mean, should I go as far as level 44? There's no guarantee on it though. Can't come in for free, that's the problem. I'll need to be able to kill it for sure if I'm going to commit to that. So maybe I just chip down with Meganium a little bit and then eat the double edge. Eat a double edge because we can. Ah yeah, eat the double edge. If I go Meganium it will be a double edge, and then actually Nidoking with Poison Barb pushing to 44 with the double edge coming down. Recoil for 12 to 15 damage. That should be a guaranteed one shot if I push to 44. Do I need Nidoking at all for the rest of the time? Possibly. I don't think so though. Just looking through now. I could be wrong. But I'll have to work the rest of it without one. Which is fine, if that's what means me getting further. In a very, very safe way, then why not? Alright, so he has Poison Bar. Let's have a look at everybody's stuff. Mystic Water for the guaranteed. Lumberry. What would we use Lumberry for here? so I didn't get put to, don't get froze, don't get put to sleep, don't get paralyzed, yeah, that sort of stuff. That's good. Lumberry, so I didn't get put to sleep. Berry juice, it doesn't actually freaking matter with you. Okay, as well, the berry juice, it could be whatever, to be honest. As for this, I guess we just go for not sure, maybe even quick claw healing, just go heal. Don't need it though. We're not gonna need it versus the Pharaoh. I guess it's more of. No, I really just don't think I'm gonna need it at all. Anything there really at all. Like, if worst comes to worst, like, it's a case of just. Wanting Lumberry just in case he goes to put me to sleep. I really just don't see it happening. Ah, fuck it. Yeah, he does it, he does it. Alright, I think we're good there. So, open with the water type, then he does the thing. We switch there. Should be fine. Do I push to 43 to open with everyone? Pushing to 43 probably seems. Maybe I'll do it the ones that I can sort of mix up a little bit. Okay, I think that's okay. Yeah, I got the right way. Okay. Okay, so the easy part. You fucking what? What the fuck? This isn't right. This calculator is fucked because that should be a kill on the calculator.
Thank you.
Oh, Jesus, little doggos. The second I sit down, they want to come out the room. They get a bit of attention. It's like, oh, you're not giving me attention anymore. Okay, fine, I'll be on my way. Right, what are we looking at? Yeah, so we were looking at Victory Bell. Bringing Pharaoh in. Sharp Beak. I could keep him at level 42. And I go 43, it's all good. So I still have the... I still have to resolve... Mantine and Raticate. Mantine, just like, just go with, Jolteon? But push to 44 Jolteon? Go Magnet Jolteon? Jolteon barely takes any damage from Mantine, so why don't we or actually the safest answer actually is Lantern. Guarantees a one shot basically with Magnet and takes even less damage, and it means I can preserve my Jolteon for moments when I'm gonna need him. So the less I use him, the less risky he is. Where is that magnet? Okay. Lantern. That's that one taken care of. And now we can focus the last one completely on whoever. So my options I'd say are Fortress, a good option. Kabutops also a good answer. Yeah, I think we get Kabutops. Kabutops with Heathen Berry. Okay. Let's bring your Aretha 43. Trying to learn Mirror Move. Mirror Move, Mirror Move. It would help if I actually knew what it did exactly. That doesn't tell me. Mirror Move uses the last move targeted at the user by a Pokemon still on the field. So anything that's used against me, I can then do back at my opponent, but I'm not, is it just me or is it doesn't seem that great? So if I switch in, they do some of it. Oh, I mean, actually, it could. Like if they did like earthquake or whatever, and you come in and you dodge it, then you can repeat it back to them. Mirror move uses the last move targeted. I'm sure it's nice, but I actually kind of like Drill Peck, I like Dry Attack, Steel Wing. All of that stuff makes perfect sense. It's just whether I want the Mud Slap or not, and I think there's still fucking play for it, honestly. Double Edge will replace Tri-Attack? And then Sky Attack will replace Drill Peck. So do we just keep Mud Slap just for the utility? I just want to know, like, I just want to know if, like, Mirror Move will work if they try to use Earthquake against me. Mirror Move will fail if no moves were targeted at the user. The user of the move that would be cool, switch out during the turn is used. Mirror Move will also always fail when used by a transformed Pokemon. A Pokemon will be able to use a move that is disabled. I have no doubt, like, in certain ways it could be useful, but I kind of like the Mud Slap. Bit of like a, oh shit, we need a little bit of RNG in our favor. So I'm gonna decline it. So yeah, it is what it is. We're opening with my fighting type. So we'll lead with Tyson. Okay, let's find this next guy. Okay, right. It's like taking on a freaking gym leader, this is. Okay, right, let's get ahead in the game. This thing has Quick Claw. As long as we don't get horrible crits, we'll be fine. Just sub twice. Hopefully he doesn't get his quick thing now, because that means we can take less damage. Okay, that went as good as I could hope for. Victory bell, victory bell. Doobie-doo-doo-doo-doo-doo-doo, here we fucking go. Hate this fucking mob. Ice beam. Go here first, because I had the miracle berry to take the ice beam. I'm gonna try put him to sleep. Where I can get rough now. Don't. Ah. Wow, it actually hit. I'm real. I say that I try to get in and do this really quickly. Go for the quick kill rather than slow burn. He's sleeping. There's a very small chance that we kill here. 20%. Just in case if they went decided to go to Doug. Just be earthquake? Yeah, for sure. Okay. And we're definitely one-shotting, which is a real difference maker. Sludge bomb. 104 max hits. Just gonna be ice beam. I'd really like to just get. Yeah, just switch. Like, I mean, I got backup options if it freezes, so it's not that bad if it does get frozen. Like, it would make things a lot easier if it just doesn't get frozen. Fuck's sake. Thank you. No, this isn't even. Yeah, fuck you, your fucking crit. Okay, gotta go this instead. I was hoping to get a sleep off, but it's not gonna happen. It's actually hitting pretty darn hard. Fucking hell. Rock slide fucking destroys this bitch. Well, I guess the only thing I got here is Psybeam. We're not really doing much damage, but we just need to do enough. Just need to do a little bit of chip damage, that's all we need to do. It shouldn't be that fucking difficult. I think they might just throw Toxic at us now. Something that I just don't want to deal with. And this will just be Waterfall. Yes, it's gonna throw out. Oh my god. Okay, that's fine. Come back here. I'm gonna do this game. I could just stay in and try and fall out. I don't lose anything from trying to do it. I don't lose anything from trying to do that. So now it'll probably be the water move or Toxic. I just want to get out of. I want to get out of this freaking pattern of being confused. So this now should just be a straight up waterfall, which we're fine with. And now, oh my god. And now we can just Thunderbolt it, right? And Thunderbolt it to death. Right, okay. Alright. Mr. Raticate, double edge every day of the week. As long as we don't get double crit. Yeah, it's basically it. As long as we don't get double crit now. That's it, we're fine. 87. He cannot kill me. And we will finish off with submission. Turned a little bit complicated, but negotiated it pretty well. Okay. Oh, we got another back-to-back. Wonderful stuff. Jesus, and this... Oh my god, this is rough. Ah, my days, dude. Anyway, I might leave it there, boys. I think I'm gonna leave it there. I think I'll just set up for the next one and then I'm gonna take a break. So we're Okay, so I think we could look at Meganium plus Rye plus, again, I think we could seriously look at one of the fighting types, water bulky ones. So either Poly or Feradigator. Maybe we can keep Lantern. Lantern's pretty great in this fight by the looks of things. And we can just back it up with another electric type. Put you in, put you in. Just go with Feraligator. Feral, we got. Jolteon's good. I could bring a fire type. Someone to absorb ice, but then bait water and ice moves where I want to as well. It's kind of nice. Oh, let's just take Poly as well, man. Like, it's the best way to go. And genuinely, it's probably even just start with fucking Jolteon as well. If we miss, we miss. Yeah. So we go this. Give Jolty on the magnets. Okay, Miracle Seed, is it required? Nope. You don't even do a very good... I think they do a very good job. You don't survive Cedra's crits. Holy crap. You absorb water, and you one-shot there. Actually, just keep it, because in case if I need to risk a crit, then I got it still. And you one-shot that way. And yeah, just so I'm clear. Yeah, Rhydon is taken out. Ampharos. Plus... this other one, if I can, for whatever reason. I'd say I still got two very decent answers in those two. Alright, okay, I think we're set up for the next fight. So I shouldn't really have to think too much. Berry Juice, don't need Mystic Water here now. Berry Juice, you don't need this. Again, go Berry Juice. Okay, everything's all sorted and ready for the next fight. Gonna save it there, boys. Thanks for watching, as always. And see you guys in the next one.